Hello friends, I am Krishna Kanjani from LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Welcome to the online lecture series on kinematics and theory of machine. In this session, we will learn about friction. Now, this topic is very much familiar with us while we are studying in primary or in secondary studies. Okay, so now over here, in this session, we will learn that how this particular topic is also required to study the mechanical engineering. Okay, so this session will cover up about the basic introduction, then law of static and dry friction, then we will learn the limiting angle of friction and angle of repulse. At the end, we will study about some numericals which are based on these theories. Okay, so without delaying further, let's start this session with the basic introduction. Now, we are very much familiar that let's consider a particle, a body which is resting on this surface. Now, if we are applying any external force on this body, let's consider we are applying P force on this body. Okay, so now, due to this external force, the body will try to move from its position. Okay, now, as we are aware that while we are applying force, some opposite force will be developed between this body and this surface. Okay, and this opposite force, which is developed due to our external force and which is resisting, or we can say which is opposing the motion, this force is known as a frictional force. Okay, so to understand this fundamental, let's consider the body. Okay, so over here, this body A, which is subjected to an external force P. Now, due to this external force P, what we are supposed that this body will try to move, or it will move from its first position to second position. But due to this external force, there will be some resisting force, and this resisting force will be in opposite direction of the motion, and this resisting force is known as a friction. Okay, so now over here we can identify that it is a resisting force. So in general, what we demand that it should not exist. But reality is that without existence of this frictional force, we can't even walk on the earth. Okay, so it is mandatory force for many of the applications. So over here we can say that this the opposing force which act in the opposite direction of the movement of the body is known as the force, or we can say the force of friction. Okay, now it is mandatory in many of the applications, for example walking on earth, or the motion of the locomotive on the rails, or we can say for power transmissions also by belt drive or gear drive, the friction is very much required. Okay, now this friction is classified into mainly two categories. First one, that is known as a static friction, and the second one, that is known as a kinetic friction. Okay, first learn static friction. So static means steady state condition. Okay, so when the body is in steady state condition and the force, the frictional force which is developed is known as a static friction. But if the body is in motion, then it is known as a dynamic, or we can say kinetic friction. Okay, now this kinetic friction is also classified into three categories: sliding, rolling and pivot friction. Okay, so now as the name indicates, in the case of sliding friction, the type of motion which is occurring between the body and the surface is sliding type. Okay, or this in now in second category, that is in rolling friction, the body will be rolling over the entire surface. For example, if you consider a circular wheel which is rolling on this flat surface, then this type of motion will produce the friction which is known as a rolling friction. And the third one, that is known as a pivot friction. Pivot means a body is rotating about some center. If you consider this one as a fixed body center, and about this center any body is completely rotating, and due to the rotation of this body, the friction which is generated is known as a pivot friction. Okay, now this friction is also classified in further two categories, which is known as a dry friction and we can say bad friction. Okay, so now first consider dry friction. Now as the name indicates, dry friction means when the body which is the two bodies which is having in contact between them, they don't have any other lubrication, or we can say any other liquid between them. so there won't be any lubrication between them. So the friction which is produced in this condition is known as a dry friction, and the value of dry friction is always high in comparison with the dry friction. If you suppose that any fluid is in between this body and the flat surface, okay, so for example, in this case, if we suppose that the water part, if a layer of water, or we can say a lubrication, is existing in between this body and this surface, then in that case the friction which is generated is known as a fluid friction, or we can say is a lubricated. This is classified into two categories, that is boundary friction and fluid friction. Okay, so this is the very basic fundamental and how we can classify the friction. Okay, now another fundamental is that the amount of friction. Okay, so let's consider that a particle which is placed over here in its initial position. Okay, now we are not applying any type of force over here. Okay, if we won't apply any type of force, then there won't be any existence of frictional force. Okay, because we can simply assume that if we will not apply any force, then how the body will move. Okay, so when we apply some amount of force, let's consider that this body will move at the force of 500 newton. What it means that when we will apply 500 newton force in this horizontal direction, then and then only the body will move. But what happen if we apply 100 newton force? Okay, if we apply 100 newton force on this body, so in that case the amount of friction which is generated between this body and this surface is known as a static friction. Okay, so when we apply some external force and the body is not moving, or we can simply say that it is in a steady state condition. Okay, so when the applied force is less than some limiting amount of force, for example over here we have assumed that 500 newton is the limiting force. Okay, if we apply 500 newton force, then the body will start moving in that direction, or it will try to just begin to move in that direction. Okay, so this amount of force is known as a limiting friction. And if we apply force less than that 500 newton, then this force due to which the friction developed is known as a static friction. Okay, now if we apply force more than 500 newton, then in that case the body will try, move in particular horizontal direction. Okay, so let's assume that if we are applying 600 or 700 newton force, so due to action of this 600 newton, the body is now moving in horizontal direction. Okay, so in that case the friction is generated, which is known as a dynamic friction, and in this particular case it is sliding type of motion, so it is considered as a dynamic, or we can say sliding friction. Okay, now in GTU examination, many of the times they will ask that state the law of static friction. So there are some fundamentals regarding static frictions. Okay, now how we can identify this? So let's consider the first fundamental, that when we apply some external force on the body, the opposite force which is produced in the opposite direction of the motion, if we apply force in horizontal direction, let's consider positive direction, so the due to this positive directional force, the negative directional force which is developed, which is opposing this motion, this negative directional force is known as a frictional force. Okay, so the first fundamental about frictional force, that it will be always in opposite direction of motion. Okay, and what will be the magnitude? Okay, so the second fundamental, that is the magnitude of this force. Okay, so first fundamental, that force of friction will always act in the direction which is opposite to the direction in which the body tends to move. Okay, now the second fundamental, let's consider the amount of force. Okay, how much frictional force will be developed? So over here, let's consider that limiting friction is once again 500 newton. So in that case, if we are applying 100 newton force over here, so due to this 100 newton force, the amount of frictional force developed will be always of the same amount, that is also of 100 newton. Okay, if we won't apply any external force, there won't be any frictional existence, because the So the body will be storing the whole weight in terms of potential energy. Okay, so the total body weight will be converted into its potential energy, and there won't be existence of any frictional force. Okay, now when the frictional force will be generated, when we will apply some external force. Okay, so let's consider that we are applying 100 Newton force, then the amount of friction will be also 100 Newton because the body is not moving in that direction. Okay, so second fundamental is that the magnitude of the force of the friction is exactly equal to the force that we are applying from our from the external side. Okay, now the third fundamental, that is the relation. Okay, so if we consider that F is the frictional force, amount of frictional force, and Rn, that is the normal reaction which is existing due to the weight of the body. Okay, so the ratio of F upon Rn will be always constant. The fourth fundamental, that the force of friction is independent of the area of the contact. Okay, so it is not depending upon the how much contact area is in between them. Okay, so you will ask a question that if we consider that if we choose the body which is having the large contact area compared to the other body which is having small contact area, although they both are having the same amount of weight. Okay, so in that case there won't be any effect on the amount of frictional force. Okay, so which factor will play role in this case? So in this case, the roughness, surface roughness, is the main criteria. Okay, so if you read this fifth law of steady friction, then you will understand that the roughness of the surface is the main criteria. Okay, if the surface is the roughness of surface is high in case of the small area, and the surface roughness is smooth in case of the large area, then over here the frictional force will be less, and over here the frictional force will be high. Okay, so in this way we can simply say that the static friction the static friction which is produced when the body is in steady state condition, which will always follow these five fundamental rules. Okay, and this is known as the law of static friction. Okay, now with the similar fundamental, the second question, that is most IMP question for GTU examination. Okay, so many times in examination it will be asked that state the law of solid friction, or in other words they will ask that dry friction. Okay, now what is dry friction? That when the body which is moving on a flat surface, or we can say simply two body which is in contact between them, if there is no existence of any lubrication between them. Okay, so in that case the fundamental or the type of friction which is developed is known as a dry friction. Okay, so over here the law of dry friction are also similar to our previous session, that is law of steady friction. Okay, but it is only differing to some terms. Let's identify that how it is different from the static friction. So the first fundamental over here is that the frictional force is directly proportional. This frictional force is directly proportional to the normal load between the surfaces. Okay, so amount of the normal load which is applied on this. Okay, second fundamental, that the force of friction is independent of the area of contact, which is similar to our static friction rules. Okay, then the third fundamental, the force of friction is depending upon the material of which the contact surface is made up of, or in other words we can say the surface roughness also. Okay, so which material is used in manufacturing the contact surface. Okay, either the surface roughness is very low, so in that case we can say the amount of friction will be high. But if the surface roughness, if we simply say that the surface is very smooth, the roughness is very less, so in that case the amount of friction will be always also very less. Okay, and the fourth fundamental is the force of friction is independent of the velocity of sliding. Over here be careful, this is very fundamental. Sometimes we assume that if a body is moving with high velocity, then the amount of friction will be depending upon this velocity. No, it is not depending upon the velocity, it is totally depending upon the roughness of the surface and the normal reaction, or we can say the weight of the body. Okay, so in this way we can identify these four laws of solid friction, or in other words we can say dry friction. Okay, now based on these laws, next fundamental, that is the limiting angle of friction. Okay, now over here in this diagram you can refer that over here, if you consider this one as the body which is moving due to this external force P. Okay, now over here the weight is identified or denoted by the symbol W. Okay, so the weight of the body will be always in downward direction. Okay, so now due to this weight of the body, there will be a normal reaction force which is perpendicular to the contact of surface. Okay, this is very fundamental thing. So whenever a body which is having weight of W and it is in contact with the surface, there will be always existence of this normal reaction force. Okay, so that is Rn. Okay, now let's consider the reaction force between the body A and the plane B, that is your Rn, reactional force. Okay, and this external force is denoted by P. So over here we can say that the angle between this resultant force, okay, now this reaction force R will be of equal and opposite to the resultant of this W and P. Okay, so if we identify the resultant of this W and P, then it is known as the R, resultant force. Okay, so now this resultant force is making an angle with this vertical line, or we can say the normal reaction Rn. This resultant force is making some angle phi with this Rn, and this angle phi is known as a limiting angle of friction. Okay, now the second fundamental, that is coefficient of friction. Now if we identify that over here, the as we have studied in the law of static friction, that the limiting friction to the normal reaction will be always a constant term. Okay, so the ratio of limiting friction to the normal reaction will be always constant, and this constant is denoted by coefficient of friction. Okay, so over here the symbol which is used for this constant is known as a mu. Okay, so this mu is nothing but the ratio of limiting friction to the normal reaction of the two bodies. Okay, so in this session we have learned about the simple fundamental, that of what is friction, which are the basic types of friction, and then we have learned the law of static and dry friction. Okay, and over here be careful that the most IMP question for GT examination are the law of dry friction. Then sometimes they will ask the definition, that what is limiting angle of friction and what is coefficient of friction. Okay, in next session we will learn some few other fundamentals of the friction, and then we will solve one numerical based on this fundamental. Okay, thank you.